So recently, Republican Congressman Matt Gaetz has been serving as a fill-in host for some of the primetime shows on Newsmax. He's done it a handful of times, I think roughly about half a dozen, five, six maybe. And another Republican lawmaker too, Representative Pat Fallon from Texas, guest hosted a Newsmax show last Friday. Now here's the thing about this. Technically, hiring a member of Congress or even offering for free to have a member of Congress host your primetime show, it's not technically illegal. But is it unethical? Oh, hell yeah, 100%. To the point where, according to a new report, even at least a few people at Newsmax are scratching their heads as to why this is even happening. One of them said recently, they told this to the Daily Beast, there is not even a pretense that Newsmax is a news organization, and of course, it violates every journalistic rule. Having a sitting member of Congress come on and spew their propaganda on your network, push their own policies on your network, talk to people who support their own policies on your network, advance the agenda of their party on your network. But here's the thing. I'm going to take this a little bit of a step further than this Daily Beast report did. Because I did a little digging. You know, homework. Because that's what we in this business should do. If you're not doing extra work, then you shouldn't be doing this. When you look at the different kinds of laws that regulate politicians, that regulate lobbyist organizations, that regulate political campaigns, and that regulate media organizations, guess what? There is, in fact, different rules for different groups about what you're allowed to do. And here's where things get interesting. Depending on what Matt Gaetz or any other Republican congressman has to say on these networks, this could be seen, whether they're getting paid or not. If they're getting paid, it could be seen as a campaign contribution. Because technically, since House of Representatives members are up for re-election every 2 years, they're basically constantly in campaign mode. And if you, as a member of Congress who's got a re-election coming up in, you know, 14 months, if you get to host a primetime show on a network, don't you think that boosts your profile? Don't you think that should be viewed as an in-kind campaign contribution? It'd be a direct campaign contribution, basically, if you're getting paid for it. I'm sure a good lawyer would be able to make that argument in court. And I'm sure that the Federal Elections Commission might want to be looking into that, because you're giving these people free exposure by allowing them the ability to host on your network, to be center stage. That kind of seems like it's blurring the lines between the laws of what's a campaign contribution, what's an in-kind contribution, and what's not. So maybe the FEC needs to look at that. Maybe because Newsmax is obviously a staunchly conservative network, but now they're even having lawmakers from their preferred political party come on as hosts on the network. I would say that blurs the line, you know, between the laws governing a media organization and a lobbyist organization, right? I mean, there's different tax laws between the two, but also because of that, there's different liability laws in terms of what you're allowed to say and what kind of protections you have regarding the First Amendment. So, you know, there could be some legal implications of that. And while I am not a lawyer, I do happen to know lots of great lawyers, and I'm pretty sure that any one of them would be able to go to court and make these successful arguments. So Newsmax better be careful, because not only are you pissing off the very people that work at your network, but with all of this, you know, letting your conservative buddies from Congress come in and host shows on your network, you're blurring a lot of different lines. And once the lines are blurred, it's pretty easy to step over them. Also, as a bit of an aside, it kind of interests me a little bit to know why there's not more backlash about this. We have sitting members of Congress sitting in as the host on conservative media shows. I mean, if AOC were to fill in for Rachel Maddow one night, conservatives would be calling for us to burn down the entire MSNBC building. So, you know, worth pointing out that hypocrisy, because this kind of seems like the thing that people should be a little bit angry about. I know there's a lot to be angry about these days. We don't want to walk around pissed off 100% of the time, but maybe make a little room to be as at least annoyed about this story as I am.
Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.